.NET 7 Preview 1, a bunch of Windows 11 updates, and an iPod that has been updated for 2022. All that and more on this episode of The Download. Welcome back to another episode of The Download. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Advocate at Microsoft. And for my hoodie this week, I am repping Seattle with my Sub Pop shirt. I didn't live here in the 1990s, but did I ever appreciate the music? So good record label, good music, good stuff. Okay, enough of all of that. Let's do this thing. So first up, to coincide with the 20th anniversary of .NET, and seriously, I cannot believe that it has been 20 years. The very first preview of .NET 7, ASP.NET 7, and the Entity Framework 7 has been released. And so I'm just going to read from the blog post, which I have linked in the show notes and the description down below to give us more insight into this. And basically, .NET 7 builds on the foundation established by .NET 6, which includes a unified set of base libraries, runtime, and SDK, a simplified development experience, and higher developer productivity. And some of the major areas of focus for .NET 7 will include improved support for cloud native scenarios, tools to make it easier to upgrade legacy projects, and simplifying the development experience by making it easier to work with containers. All really good stuff. And so this release also comes alongside .NET MAUI Preview 13 and a new preview release of Visual Studio 17.2. So one thing to note on this, .NET 7 is a current release, meaning that it'll be receiving support and patches for 18 months from its release date, unlike the long-term servicing release, which is .NET 6. So there are more details in the blog post that I've got linked in the show notes and the description down below, but this is really exciting stuff. All right, next up, speaking of Visual Studio, Visual Studio 17.1 is now available. And we actually discussed this a couple weeks ago. And so some of the big new features here are the fact that the team has turned on the indexed find in files to default, which will make it much faster for developers to be more productive when searching throughout their projects. And there's also a slew of new Git features. There are some C++ enhancements and more. And I've got details on how you can download the latest release, as well as the Visual Studio 2022 17.2 Preview 1, which I mentioned beforehand. All of that is in the show notes and the description. Okay, so moving on to some Windows 11 news. The first big feature update for Windows 11 came out this week, and this is a big one, and it brings both the Amazon App Store preview to the Microsoft Store, meaning that you can now run Android apps on Windows 11. Very cool. And then there are some taskbar enhancements, like the ability to have like a global mute switch, and so PowerToys fans will recognize this because a similar feature also exists in PowerToys. Also, big news, the clock can finally be displayed on a second monitor. I know that a lot of people have been asking for that, so very exciting. And some classic Windows apps have been given a more modern makeover, including the media player, and I have to say it, Notepad. That's right, Notepad has been redesigned. There's a dark mode, it's has a new find and replace mode, and I'm going to say it, the Notepad is sexy now. It is, so very good stuff. I've got some details on the latest features and how you can get them in the show notes and the description. That's really good stuff. But speaking of Windows 11 stuff, in addition to the features that are now available for everyone, there's still a ton of other Windows 11 news out there. So the latest Windows 11 Insider Preview builds on the Dev Channel, has a ton of features that are based on user feedback and some enhancements. So this includes improvements to the Start menu. You can now create folders in the pinned apps area of Start, which I know will make a lot of people happy. There are some new Do Not Disturb and Focus modes. There's the ability to have live captions. There's some better quick access stuff in File Explorer, new touch gestures, and most exciting to me personally is that the Task Manager has been given an update, so it's now like in the 21st century and it doesn't look like Windows 95. It's like Notepad, very hot, very sexy. So again, these new features are in the Dev Channel for the Windows Insiders, but that means that everyone's going to see them sometime in the next few months. So stay tuned for more details of that, and I've got more info in the show notes and the description. Okay, so next, I somehow missed this a couple of weeks ago, but Windows Terminal 1.13 Preview is now available, and this is actually the first big release in 2022. And as a reminder, you can actually have Windows Terminal and Windows Terminal Preview installed side by side, which is great. And the new version has an updated UI design, which looks really great. But for me, the biggest feature and the reason that I'm talking about this is that there's a new profile setting called Elevate that will allow you to automatically launch a profile elevated as an administrator. So you can also hold down the control button and immediately have a dropdown to open a profile as administrator. And this is really exciting because it cuts down on one of the pain points that I've had with Windows Terminal. Because look, like, I'm a Unix person, so I'm just used to using sudo to elevate my status. So this feature, the way that the team handled this has been a long-standing request, and the way that the terminal team handled this change, I think, is really elegant, is really smart. The new version also has a new text rendering engine in preview that you can enable, and there's some new sounds, there's more stuff too. More details are in the show notes and the description, but it's awesome, and this will be coming to the regular Windows Terminal builds in the next few weeks. Okay, speaking of awesome, I've been really, really hyped on PWAs or progressive web apps over the last couple of months. And if you have wanted to get started learning about PWAs and how to build them, you should definitely check out the new 30 Days of PWA blog that's over at GitHub. And so members of the Microsoft Edge, the Windows, and the developer relations teams, including my pals Aaron and Beth and Nitya and Justin, have all created this great content that is basically designed to get you started with PWAs and their daily posts and exercises. It'll take you through the entire journey. It's really good stuff. I've got links in the show notes and the description so you can check it out. You can also contribute feedback and even make content requests and even collaborate if that's your thing, because again, this is all on GitHub, so that's really awesome. So be sure to check that out if you are into PWAs, 30 days of PWA. All right, next, for the Markdown lovers amongst us, and that is definitely me, GitHub has added the ability to add diagrams in your Markdown files using a JavaScript library called Mermaid. And basically, this will allow you to insert charts and graphs in a syntax that's been inspired by Markdown. And so if you're not familiar, Markdown, the idea is that basically you can write easy to read plain text that can then be converted into HTML. And the whole idea is that it's easy to read, so you don't have to go through the source code and read, you know, tags and other formatting stuff. So what Mermaid does is it's really similar, except that it's designed for diagrams and charts, including flowcharts, UML, Git graphs, and journey diagrams, and even Gantt charts. So instead of having to manually code those charts, you just use this syntax that is easy to read, and then you can insert it in your documents. And so what the GitHub team has done is that they've worked with Svedets, honestly, the creator of Mermaid, and I'm so sorry, I cannot say your name. They've also worked with the broader Common Mark community to support adding Mermaid syntax into GitHub. So that means that anything that you're writing on GitHub in Markdown, think like release notes or issues or wiki pages, can now support these charts in line, which is really great. Now it is time for my pick of the week. Okay, so this one comes courtesy of Ellie Huxtable, and she wrote a fantastic blog post showing basically how she turned an old iPod video into something modern for 2022. I love this so much. Basically, she took apart like an iPod video, 5.5G, so I don't know, this is like 2006, 2007, and she made it a whole lot better. She added a new, bigger, better battery, a new case, more modern storage. She even updated the firmware, and the result is a modern MP3 player that still retains all the stuff that made the iPod so great, like a really good DAC and really great offline features, because sometimes you just don't want to stream, you just want to listen to your music. Anyway, I've got an iPod video that I love dearly, and I'm very seriously considering doing something similar to this. So great stuff, Ellie, appreciate it. All right, well, that does it for me this week. Let me know what old tech that you would like to modernize in the modern era in the comments down below, but you can also share your thoughts on any of the other stories we talked about today. And if you liked this episode, go ahead and give us the thumbs up on YouTube. And while you're there, go ahead and subscribe to Microsoft Developer for all your nerd needs. See you next time.